remember when you hear, sometimes you remember when you see, but when you hear and when you see, you remember especially well, don't you? Today I wrote the name of the word. Our special word today is the wonder of a... You think it's going to say manger? Angel? The wonder of an angel? I don't know. I'll tell you what. I brought this marker right here. And if I do this... Wait a minute. I hold it down so I can see what I'm doing. Watch this. Oh, does it say manger? And there's the R. Yeah, the wonder of a manger. What is a manger? That is a manger. And we know the story that Mary and Joseph went to, what town was it? Bethlehem, that's right. They went to Bethlehem because they had to be counted. And while they were there, it came time for Mary to have her baby. And the scripture says what? She laid him in a
bed of hay.
A bed of hay in the
manger.
She laid him in the manger. So for all we know, and for, it's hard to remember, guys, that these kids only know that a manger is where they put baby Jesus. So it's like a baby bed. But guess what? You know what the manger actually was? It was sort of a table. It was where they would put hay for the animals to eat. It's just about the right height if you were a horse to eat hay out of that, or if you were a donkey to eat hay out of that. So it was really a feeding trough. Is that a good crib for baby Jesus, do you think? Oh, you would think Jesus would have the best crib with the sweetest, nice satin sheets and... You were right, Kendall. She said back then you couldn't buy that if you weren't rich. And so Jesus was born in a very humble way. What do you want to say, Austin?
They didn't have grocery stores or stores back then.
They didn't have grocery stores or a whole lot of stores back then either. And so Mary and Joseph had to use what they had. And you would think that since Jesus was the one who would come to save the whole entire world, that he would have something much nicer, wouldn't you? But do you know what? Jesus loves us so much that he was born in a stable. Do you know what a stable is? What?
It's where they keep
the animals.
Kind of like a barn.
Kind of like a barn. That's exactly right. A stable is right where you put lots of animals. How do you think it smells in a stable?
Kind
of yucky, kind of stinky, yeah.
If you cleaned it out and didn't have any animals,
it would be so stinky, but I think all the animals were right there. You wouldn't have to clean it if you didn't have animals, that's right. So it was very... That's right, that's right. They're built out of tape. Did you make one in Sunday school? They're built out of tape sometimes. You didn't? Okay. So today, when you and every time you see a manger scene, and when you see Jesus who was born in a stable in the town of Bethlehem with his mother Mary and his father Joseph, and when you see the shepherds and the wise men and the angels, you remember how much Jesus loves you. That he would come from heaven to be on earth with us. That's how much he loves us. That he was born in a stable and laid in a manger. That's a wonderful thing. God was the first human, huh? Yeah. That's a whole other story, Austin. We'll talk about that on another day. That starts in the beginning, God created. Well, it's Jesus' birthday on Christmas, so Jesus and God are one, and the Holy Spirit, and that's, you guys have such deep theology, and I'm getting in deep trouble here, so those are all things that we'll have to talk about later, because you are so smart. It's so frightening. They're smarter than we are, isn't it? So let's say our prayers. Thank you for helping to lead us in worship today. Let's Dear God, we love you so much. We thank you for Jesus, who came to live with us, who was born in a stable and laid in a manger. And we thank you that you love us that much. God bless you, Lord. Amen.